Hello friends, my name is Jaydeep Banne. I am uploading the second chapter of physics standard 11. I am also upload, you can see the first chapter uploaded unit and measurement, and then see you the second chapter, that is mathematical method. This is one of the simple chapter, and this in the chapter we are they are giving scalar vectors, addition of vector, multiplication of vector, and vector products and scalar product, scale vector product, vector cross product, vector dot product, and also given that is in some part of integration, some part of derivative. Friends, that is exercise I am uploaded, I am given, I will uploaded the exercises in this all chapters. First that is question is that the resultant of two forces 10 newton and 15 newton acting along positive x-axis and negative x-axis respectively, and we are given 25 newton along positive x-axis, 25 newton along negative x-axis, 5 newton along positive x-axis, 5 newton along negative x-axis. I will solving the questions. First we are given F1 is equal to 10 newton along positive x-axis, and F2 is given minus 15 newton. We are giving minus because this is negative x-axis, and we are the resultant force is equal to F1 plus F2, that is 10 minus 15 is equal to minus 5. Minus means negative x-axis and 5 newton. The answer is 5 newton along negative x-axis. 5 newton along negative x-axis. 5 newton along negative x-axis. Second, for two vectors of equal, they should have the, if two vectors are equal, then same magnitude and same direction. If two vectors are same magnitude and same direction, then they are equals. Then third question, the magnitude of scalar product of two unit vectors perpendicular to each other is, we are given the magnitude of scalar product of two unit vectors. There are two unit vectors perpendicular to each other. We know that this is a scalar product, or also called as a dot product. If P dot Q is equal to 0, therefore the two vectors are perpendicular. Also, that is, we know that vector P dot vector Q is equal to PQ cos theta. Therefore, P, that is one unit vector, vector Q, that is these are two magnitudes and cos theta, 1 into 1 into cos 90. The value of cos 90 is 0, therefore 0 into 1 into 0, that is 0. Therefore, vector P dot vector Q is equal to 0. All that clear? If anyone doubt, please comment on this comment box. The magnitude of vector product of two unit vectors making an angle 60 degree with each other. They are having two unit vectors, I cap and j cap. Consider vector P, and vector P of in magnitude is 1, and vector Q of magnitude is 1. An angle is given 60 degree. We are giving the vector product of two unit vectors. Vector product, vector P cross vector Q is equal to PQ sin theta. We are given magnitude of vector P means is also called as P. Magnitude of vector Q is also called as Q. Therefore, P is equal to 1, Q is equal to 1, and sin, that is 60 degree. We know that sin 60 is equal to root 3 by 2, and here multiplication root 3 by 2 sorry root sorry 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 root 3 by 2. So answer is root 3 by 2. If vector A, vector B and vector C are 3 vectors, then which of the following is not correct? Which of the following is not correct? Not correct. They are asking a not correct. That is incorrect. Not correct means that is incorrect. First, that vector A in bracket vector A dot in bracket vector B plus C is equal to A vector A dot vector B plus vector A dot vector C. That is first is correct. Second is vector A dot vector B is equal to vector B dot vector A. Second also correct. That is third dot product is correct. Next, vector A cross vector B is equal to vector B cross vector A. The third, that is wrong, because vector A cross vector B is equal to minus of B vector B cross vector A.